The next witness is Megper Ordemann, in support, not testifying. And we have John Mark Antonio from Rhode Island Business Association, in support, not testifying. And then our final witness is Tony DeSisto from CRMC, who I know will be testifying.
Thank you, Madam.
Nice to see you again, John.
Thank you, yes. CRMC, and I can say this as the attorney, they support this legislation. And you know, it's, there's been work going on this bill actually for some time. I know that Save the Bay and the governor's staff have been going back and forth and working on the bill. We were aware of that. We were allowed to have input on it. And you know, part of it is being driven by, there is a lawsuit that Save the Bay filed on this matter, on this issue. And I think this bill is an attempt to address some of those issues. I agree with the comments of the chair. I know that there have been attempts in previous years to amend this legislation. It just never quite made it on the other side. But this has been going on for some time. I have concerns as the legal counsel of the CRMC and the current structure. You have a 46-23-2, which was never amended. And it appears to me that, as John said, you've basically been operating on the appointments for the governor as well as Senate confirmations on the 2008 case in re request for advisory opinion from the House of Representatives for the Coastal Resources Management Council. And that's at best an awkward situation. I think this bill addresses that. And I'd just like to say one other thing, because the Coastal Resources Management Council and Mr. O'Neill, I think, alluded to that. There's a wide range of activities for this management and regulatory agency that was designed specifically for that part of Rhode Island, from the harbor lines to 200 feet within the coastal feature. When it was created in 1971, there was an acknowledgement that Rhode Island's coastline was very important to preserve, and the answer was to come up with the Coastal Resources Management Council, which was specifically charged for that area. Since 1971, the issues have only become more complex and more important to Rhode Island, based on things like global warming and sea level rise, and also with a different mix of uses that we see now in this important area. And it goes from, as I don't know if she's still here, but one of the witnesses testified about her dad going for a dock. CRMC permits docks. It goes from residential docks all the way out to Cape Wind and the Revolution Wind and Deep Water Wind. Now, that happens because Rhode Island has one of the most advanced coastal resources management plans in the United States. Three are considered in the top: Rhode Island, New York, and California. Rhode Island has an addition of special area management plans, which includes an ocean special area management plan, which would regulate all uses out beyond Rhode Island's coastal limit of 3 miles. So this is an important agency, and I think this bill is something that is needed to make sure that as these issues come forward, that Rhode Island will be able to adequately meet those issues on that. And by the way, in a public area. Now, sometimes decisions don't go the way that people want them to, but I will say, just to follow up on Topher's comments, that they are in the public, they are open to the public, and other regulatory agencies that operate with hearing officers don't afford that type of opportunity for people to speak. Sometimes what happens is the decision doesn't go the way that people want it to, but it is out in the open and it can be discussed. If there are any questions about this bill or the Coastal Resources Management Council, I'll do my best to answer.
Thank you very much, Tom. Any questions?
You let me off easy. Thank you.
Thank you.